How's it going?
Good.
Good. Doing all right?
Yeah.
Sweet. I'm gonna run this down to your boy.
Yeah. My radio is mostly static. Is that normal?
Yes.
Okay.
But when people talk, you're able to hear what they say, though, right?
Mostly. Sometimes.
Okay.
Mostly.
If it gets too bad, we might have to switch you out.
Okay.
Let's go!
That's a good problem to have.
doing stuff better through the radio now.
Okay, good, good.
Coming through good now.
Jack Richardson Field inside Hale Memorial Stadium for tonight's contest between the visiting Rebels of Park Hill Central and your own Farmington Knights. sports. Farmington High School is a proud member of the Missouri State High School Activities Association, and we remind all spectators that this game is competitive, but is also an educational experience for all players and students. We encourage all spectators at tonight's game to keep in mind that good sportsmanship is expected as we set a positive example for our students and players. To start off the evening, we will be celebrating Senior Night. And tonight we would like to recognize our seniors and their families in the football category. Our first senior this evening is Mr. Lucas Berkner. Lucas is the son of Christopher Mini Berkner. He is also a member of the National Honor Society. His favorite memory was his first game here last year against Potosi. Lucas plans to study logistics in the Air Force. Lucas Berkner. Our next senior is Parker Brooks. Parker is the son of Lamar and Jennifer Brooks, Mickey and Steve Osborne. He's also a member of Track, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and Standing on Scriptures. His favorite memory is when they beat North County this year. Parker plans to enlist in the Marine Corps and get his college education while enlisted. Parker Brooks.
Really?
Next up is Damian Cabrera. Tonight you will be escorted by Stephanie Cabrera and Grandad Steve Larkin. Your favorite memory is when they won against Lit for Life in the last couple seconds of the game. Damian plans to continue his career in construction on the National
He has a
cape on. Gabriel Giuliani. Yeah. Bluff in the final seconds of sophomore year in the homecoming game. Dave plans to attend Missouri State to study engineering. Gabriel Giuliani.
Our next senior is Hunter Hastings. Hunter is the son of Larry and Anna Hastings. He is also a member of the wrestling team. His favorite memory is joining the football team his senior year. Hunter plans to go straight to work as an apprentice electrician. Hunter Hastings. Next up is Bryce Cathcart. Bryce is the son of Shane Cathcart and Jessica Petitis. His favorite memory is when they beat Papa Bluff on homecoming his sophomore year by a touchdown the very last second of the game. Bryce is going to Rankin to pursue HVAC. Bryce Cathcart. Our next senior is Rhett Coughlin. Rhett is the son of Vince and Jessica Coughlin. He's also a member of the golf team. His favorite memory is when they beat Lift for Life with a last second field goal. Rhett plans to attend Mineral Area College after graduation. Rhett Coughlin. Next up is Aiden Saunders. Aiden is the son of Adam and Dina Saunders. His favorite memory is when they beat North County. Aiden plans to play football for Friends University after graduation. Aiden Saunders. Our next senior is Chase Watson. Chase is the son of Scott and Christy Watson. He's also a member of the track team. His favorite memory is beating North County. Chase plans to attend Missouri S&T while studying to become a mechanical engineer. Chase Watson. Our next senior is Ethan Weiss. Ethan is the son of Adam Weiss and Katie Pollock. He's also a member of Future Farmers of America. His favorite memory is when they beat Lift for Life on the last second field goal. Ethan plans to attend Mineral Area College after graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, Ethan Weiss. Our last football senior is Mr. Samuel Woodson. Sam's the son of Brian and Lynette Woodson. He's also a member of the track and basketball team. Favorite memories are the hug from Coach Murphy and Dave Burke. Sam plans to attend college after graduation. Ladies and gentlemen, Samuel Woodson. Let's have another round of applause for our senior football team. Next up for Senior Night, we would like to celebrate our cheer team. our first senior. Our first senior is Lillian Gaines. She's the daughter of Paul and Bishop Gaines. She's also a member of the Health Occupation Students of America. Her favorite memory is her arabesque incident while recording for competition her freshman year. Lillian plans to attend Mizzou to major in diagnostic medical ultrasound. Ladies and gentlemen, Lillian Gaines. Our next senior is Kira Hayes.
Hey buddy, how you
doing? Go Kira!
Kira's the daughter of Matt and Jessica
Hayes.
She's also a member of the National Honor Society and Knights in Action. Her favorite memory is when they were at cheer camp the summer before her sophomore year, and Coach Shaylin went to run up the stairs in the gym during All-American tryouts, and she had a little stumble in front of the judges section. Kira plans to go to Maryville University to join their stunt team while getting a degree in marketing. Kira Hayes. Our next senior is Miss Sierra Copeland. Sierra is the daughter of Michael and Sheree Warden and John Copeland. She's also a member of Yearbook and Health Occupation Students of America. Her favorite memory is when she was at practice her sophomore year. Coach Shaylin was helping her practice her round off, and she forgot her hands and face planted into the mat. Sierra plans to attend Mineral Area College to get her associate's degree along with her real estate license. Sierra Copeland. Our final senior for the cheer team is Miss Brooke Ladd. Brooke is the daughter of Norman and Karen Ladd. She's also a member of the choir. Her favorite memory is when she got really excited that their stunt hit at a game, so she screamed really loud over the entire band, the fans, and the cheer team. Brooke plans to attend a four-year university to study dental hygiene and become a cheer coach on the side. Ladies and gentlemen, Brooke Ladd. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause for the senior cheer team. Yeah. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to recognize the senior marching band members and their parents. Our first senior is Zane Boren. Zane is the son of Michelle and Brian Boren. Zane has represented the band at the MAAA All-Conference Honor Band, as well as at the District Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Zane is also involved with the high school bowling team at the Family Fun Center in Bon Terre and community ensembles through the Mineral Area Fine Arts Academy. Upon graduation, Zane plans on attending a four-year university to study music. Ladies and gentlemen, Zane Bourne. Our next senior is Natalie Dace. Natalie is the daughter of Rachel Horvath. Natalie is a member of the Black Knight Marching Band clarinet section. Natalie is also involved with Future Teachers of America. Upon graduation, Natalie plans on going to college to study education. Ladies and gentlemen, Natalie Dace. Our next senior is Kaylee Denoyer. Kaylee is the daughter of Pam and Matt Denoyer. Kaylee is currently a member of the Color Guard and plays baritone in Loud and Proud, which she played in the Black Knight Marching Band for 3 years. Kaylee is also involved with FFA and the Health Occupation Students of America. Upon graduation, Kaylee plans on attending medical school to study emergency medicine. Ladies and gentlemen, Kaylee Denoyer. Our next senior is Cale Dixon. Cale is the son of Randy Priday and Jared Dixon. Cale represents the band as a member of its leadership team. Cale has also represented the band at the All-District Honor Band as well as at District Solo and Ensemble Music Festivals. Cale is also involved with Air Force JROTC. And upon graduation, Cale plans on serving in the U.S. Navy as a nuclear engineer. Ladies and gentlemen, Cale Dixon. Our next senior is Cadence Donlin. Cadence is the daughter of Rochelle and Michael Donlin. Cadence has represented the band in the NAAA All-Conference Honor Band and the District Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Upon graduation, Cadence plans on attending Black Hills State University to study forensic chemistry. Ladies and gentlemen, Cadence Donlin. Our next senior is Gavin Eaton. Gavin is the son of Laura Willis and Robert Eaton. Gavin has represented the band at the NAAA All-Conference Honor Band as well as at District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Gavin is also involved with the FHS swim team, and upon graduation, Gavin plans on earning an EMT certification and then studying nursing. Ladies and gentlemen, Gavin Eaton. Next up is Zach Gallagher. Zach is the son of Colleen and Bill Gallagher. Zach represents the band as a member of its leadership team. And Zach has also represented the band in the All-District Honor Band, the NAAA All-Conference Honor Band, as well as at District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festivals. He's also involved with Knights in Action, Health Occupation Students of America, and Scholar Bowl. Upon graduation, Zach plans on pursuing a career in emergency medical services. Ladies and gentlemen, Zach Gallagher. Next up is Maisie Hahn. Maisie is the daughter of Jessica Farmer and Brandon Hahn. Maisie is involved with Loud and Proud Pep Band, Jobs for America's Graduates, and A-plus Tutoring. Upon graduation, Maisie plans on becoming a real estate agent. Ladies and gentlemen, Maisie Hahn. Our next senior is Eli Halleck. Eli is the son of Lynette and Isaac Halleck. Eli represents the band as a member of its leadership team. Eli has also represented the band at District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festivals. Eli is also involved with Quad Theater, the Mineral Area Fine Arts Academy, and helps lead music at First Baptist Church of Delaware. Upon graduation, Eli plans on attending Missouri Baptist University. Ladies and gentlemen, Eli Halleck. Our next senior is Emily Herbst. Emily is the daughter of Deborah Hodges and Shannon and Matt Hurt. Emily is a member of the Black Knight Marching Band Color Guard. She's also involved with Jobs for America Graduates, Emergency Medical Responders, A-plus Tutoring, and is a gymnast at Farmington Creative Arts Center. Upon graduation,
Emily plans on working at the St. Francis County Ambulance District while attending MAC and eventually studying paramedicine. Ladies and gentlemen, Emily Hertz.
Woo! Yeah!
Next up is Edward Jones. Edward is the son of Jody Harris and Brandon Harris. Eddie has represented the band at the All-District Honor Band, the MAAA All-Conference Honor Band, as well as at the District Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Upon graduation, Eddie plans on studying precision machining to obtain a career in the aerospace field. Ladies and gentlemen, Edward Jones. Our next senior is Emma Jones. Emma is the daughter of Belinda Ramey and Clay Jones. Emma represents the Black Knight Marching Band as a member of its leadership team and as a member of the Color Guard. Upon graduation, Emma plans on attending Mineral Area College to begin pursuing a medical degree. Ladies and gentlemen, Emma Jones. Next up is Caroline Klump. Caroline is the daughter of Amy and Matt Klump. Caroline has represented the band in the MAAA All-Conference Honor Band. Caroline is also a member of National Honor Society, Latin Honors, Wrestling, and Track and Field. Upon graduation, Caroline plans on attending the Missouri University of Science and Technology to study chemical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, Caroline Klump. Our next senior is Pamela Marlowe. Pamela is the daughter of Rhonda and Ron Marlowe. Pam has represented the band at the District and Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Pam is also involved with Standing on Scripture, Theater Guild, Future Business Leaders of America, National Honor Society, and Knights in Action. Pam will graduate with her associate's degree through MAC and plans on attending a four-year university to study psychology, music education, or theater education. Ladies and gentlemen, Pam Marlowe. Next up is Grayson Pratt. Grayson is the daughter of Angela Meekle and Matt Pratt. Grayson was chosen as this year's Black Knight Marching Band homecoming candidate and represents the Black Knight Marching Band on its leadership team. Grayson has represented the band at the MAAA All-Conference Honor Band and at District and State Solo and Ensemble Festival. Grayson is also involved with Scholar Bowl, Knights in Action, Future Business Leaders of America, Theater Guild, and Embrace Equality. Upon graduation, Grayson will graduate with her associate's degree from MAC and plans to attend Truman State University to study psychology. Ladies and gentlemen, Grayson Pratt. Our next senior is Wesley Reed. Wesley is the son of Gina and John Reed. Wesley is currently a private in the Army National Guard. Wesley is also involved with JROTC. And upon graduation, Wesley plans on continuing his career in the Army and attending college. Ladies and gentlemen, Wesley Reed. Our next senior is Mandy Roper. Mandy is the daughter of Joanna Hart and Christoph Roper. Mandy has represented the band in the All-District Honor Band, the MAAA All-Conference Honor Band, as well as District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festivals. Mandy is also involved in choir, National Honor Society, and Knights in Action. Upon graduation, Mandy plans on studying architectural acoustics at the University of Kansas. Ladies and gentlemen, Mandy Roper. Next up is Levi Short. Levi is the son of Jennifer and Matthew Short. Levi is a member of the Black Knight Marching Band Trumpet Section. Upon graduation, Levi plans on going to college to study architecture. Ladies and gentlemen, Levi Short. Our next senior is Eli Sullivan. Eli is the son of Aaron and Robert Sullivan. Eli serves the marching band as a drum major on its leadership team.
Eli has represented the band at multiple events, including the NAAA All-Conference Honor Band, the All-District Honor Band, as well as District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Eli is also involved with Theater Guild, Knights in Action, Choir, National Honor Society, and the Mineral Area Fine Arts Academy. Upon graduation, Eli will have his associate's degree from MAC and will study music education at Southeast Missouri State University. Ladies and gentlemen, Eli Sullivan. Our next senior is Charles Warren. Charles is the son of Flora and David Warren. Charles represents the band as a member of its leadership team. Charles has represented the band in the East Central All-District Band, the NAAA All-Conference Honor Band, as well as at District and State Solo and Ensemble Music Festival. Charles is also involved with Knights in Action, National Honor Society, Boy Scouts of America, and community groups through the Mineral Area Fine Arts Academy. Upon graduation, Charles plans on attending a university to study music. Ladies and gentlemen, Charles Warren. Senior band members, thank you for your dedication and leadership that you have shared with the Farmington Band program. You all have bright futures ahead of you. Always remember to be great people first, good musicians second, and live your life with no regrets. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the 2023 Black Knight Marching Band seniors. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you would, please stand and remove your hats for the playing of the National Anthem. Flag will be presented by the Farmington High School Air Force Junior ROTC, and the National Anthem will be performed by the Farmington High School Marching Band under the direction of Mr. Elliot Nays and Mary Porter.
Raising money for the Gateway to Hope Foundation. Gateway to Hope is a breast cancer foundation located in Maplewood, Missouri. Gateway to Hope's mission is to champion change by removing barriers to affordable, timely, quality breast health care and empowering to live free and healthy lives. Last year, we raised just over $5,000. So far this year, we have raised $3,000. We have a table set up near the concession stand with items for purchase such as shirts, glasses,
this guy's just up here, right?
Yeah,
should be.
Or you can show your support by participating in a Miracle Minute. This is where both sides have 1 minute to collect as much money as possible. It could be change or bills, anything counts. We thank you in advance for your support.
We welcome you to Hale Memorial Stadium, side of our high school football game tonight between the Farmington Knights and the Central Rebels, and the broadcasting debut of three very talented freshmen in the BK TV program. You'll be hearing tonight from Judge Aubuchon, you'll be hearing tonight from Xander Davis, and you'll be hearing tonight from Jasper LeMons, as I'll be giving you the play-by-play and analysis of tonight's football game between the Central Rebels and the Farmington Knights. Judge, what's on your mind about this game?
We would like to thank our sponsors tonight. Domino's in Farmington, Missouri, thank you guys. Ryan Blankenship Insurance Agency. And Jimmy John's in Farmington, Missouri. Thank you, sponsors.
Fantastic. Talk a little bit about the game tonight, guys. Judge, first off, I know you're very familiar with the Farmington Knights football team. They've had some struggles the last few games. What do they need to do tonight to pick up a victory over a pretty good Central team?
Well, we really just need to keep our minds to ourselves and ignore any trash talk or anything like that. I mean, it seems like that's what coach wants us to do best, is just ignore everyone who talks bad, support our BKP.
Xander, I wanted to ask you a little bit about Tatum Tinsley, a guy that's had to take on a lot of extra responsibilities with the Farmington Knights this year due to the injury to Brett Dry. Talk a little bit about how he's improved and learned, kind of taking over at that quarterback position.
Yeah, Tatum Tinsley is very good player overall. He really puts in the work, always putting up others. He really helps out the team with our school spirit. When everybody's down in practice, he always gets everybody cheered up. He pays attention to the game, doesn't trash talk at all, very good, pays attention, gets everybody in line if nobody's listening. He's just a good person and player overall. There's nothing really bad you could say about that man.
Jasper LeMons, I wanted to ask you about some of the linemen up front, some of the big guys and their responsibilities and what they've had to do this year to make waves for the Tinsleys, for the Giulianis, for those guys carrying the football.
I'd say we have a very good starting offensive line. We've got Corey Crawford at center, Scott Firth at left guard, Aiden Saunders at right guard. He's being replaced by Ethan Weiss because he's injured right now. We have Luke Berkner at right tackle and Bryce Cathcart at left tackle. These are all very big, strong men. Bryce Cathcart's a senior. Scott Phillips a sophomore. Corey Crawford's a junior. Aiden Saunders is a senior. And Ethan Weiss is a senior as well. Luke Berkner's a senior. And I just say overall we have a very strong and pretty quick, nice, very good offensive line. And they're good on D-line too.
Absolutely. Those guys will be playing both ways a lot tonight. In fact, a lot of the players you'll see on both of these squads will be playing both ways here this evening. Central's dominated this matchup for the last few years. 2019 was the last time the Farmington Knights won. And I know you guys have some of that information in front of you about kind of the history of the series and how it's gone. And looks like it... has been a while since the Knights won, and tell us, Xander, what happened that night.
Well, that night, it was very tough loss, but it was a good win. It really felt good to win after a while, because our season's not going too bad. We've lost a couple of games, but we really put back the work, trying to come back from our losses. We got to really thank our coaches who really helped us get to there. But our wins, it really feels good to win every once in a while, you know?
Judge, I wanted to ask you about some of these playmakers with Central. I know everybody in the area that follows basketball in some way, shape, or form knows about Bryant and what he's able to do. But he's not the only guy that's been making plays for the Central Rebels this year, is he?
No, sir, he is not. There is, I mean, Joe Bryant, he's a great player. He's quite the athlete. He's a great person on defense. He's a great player on offense. He does a whole lot for his team. And then we also got Caden Casey. He's a wide receiver. I haven't heard much about him, but I know that he's a pretty good player. And then tonight, I believe that Cason Murphy is starting at QB because he is back from his injury, I've heard. I haven't heard a whole lot because I haven't been caught up with them, but I believe that Cason Murphy is going to be our starting QB for Central Rebels tonight.
And he's since he's returned, he's been able to distribute the football around. Doesn't have the mobility that he had in the earlier part of the season, but anytime you can bring that player back, and then Jasper, that allows Bryant to move out to the wide receiver, and in essence, like, give Central another weapon with that injury return.
Yes, it does. Sometimes when players are injured, we have to take them from other positions because they're very skilled. They can be very dynamic and move them around, you know, as Joe Bryant played QB, pretty sure, for a few, maybe one or two games. But they're a very dynamic team, most of their skilled players. But this is going to be a pretty good game tonight, I'd say.
All right, that is our pregame look at our broadcast game here tonight on BKTV, as we have the Central Rebels and the Farmington Knights about to do battle. Both teams are at the 50-yard line. Coach Eric Krupe of the Knights, Coach Corey Schweiss of the Central Rebels. And these guys have faced off against each other for a long time. And another chapter will be written tonight in the history of the Farmington Knights and the Central Rebels in their football rivalry. So both teams at the 50-yard line on the night head, getting ready to have the coin toss as the officials will go over things, and both coaches shaking hands and jogging back to their respective sidelines. All right, so I gotta ask you guys this. I know you guys are all Madden players, or what's the name of the phone game that you guys play all the time? On your phones in class, the football game, Xander, what is it?
That would be Retro Bowl, Mr. Lowry.
Retro Bowl, thank you very much. So I got to ask, do you guys, when you're playing Retro Bowl or Madden or whatever, NFL Blitz, whatever video game you're playing, do you want the ball to start the game or do you want it in the second half?
I would love to start with the ball.
What about you other guys?
I enjoy starting with the ball because it gives me a great chance to get the kickoff return and then gain a little bit of yardage if I can, and then I'll play out from there on offense.
What about you, Jasper?
In Retro Bowl, I'd say I like to receive first because my team is pretty good at offense in mobile games, and I'd like to make an attack first rather than get scored on, rather.
Well, in the course of naming games, I lost track of who actually won the toss and who will be getting the ball first, but we'll find out here in just a few seconds. Farmington Central doing battle here on BKTV, and it looks like the Knights will be kicking off to the Central Rebels, and that means Ian Zoner will be on the tee. He's had a great year, this guy has, hasn't he? Zoner's had a great year for the Farmington Knights, kicking the football. And it's pink out night, as you can see on the YouTube channel. We got a lot of pink socks, shoes, and tape. And we are about to kick it off back deep for the Central Rebels at this time. To return that kickoff is
Braden Berry.
All right, so Berry back deep. He wears number 3. All right, Judge Aubuchon, tell us what's happening with some high school football on BKTV.
Kicking off for the Knights is Ian Zoner, number 12, and it's off. It's an onside returned by number 4,
brought down by Caden Casey.
Karius Foster, he almost had that. He got through a little bit. He made it on to, I believe, the 40, and they'll be starting on offense for tonight. Looks like the snap was on two and they were trying to fake him for 5 yards. Looks like Farmington Knights have three safeties tonight and three linemen. Joe Bryant with the carry, and he gains about, I'd say, 6-7 yards.
Brought down by Josh McCarthy, the freshman.
Josh McCarthy is a freshman starting on varsity defense. He's very skilled. He really deserves that spot. He's very athletic. Very can be bended.
And it's turned to 49. 49 on the carry. Taken down right on, I believe, the chains.
Brought down by Case McLean.
Number 49, Jackson Jones. On the carry, and he was taken down by
Casey McLean.
Braden Berry out wide. The snap is off, and it is thrown to number one, Cannon Harlow.
Pushed out of bounds, or he could say tackled, by Tatum Tinsley.
The snap's off. It was a little high. Joe Bryan on the carry. Taken down by
Gabe Giuliani with the trip. Tatum Tinsley there to help.
Gabe Giuliani is overall a very great player. He is very good defensive linebacker. Also plays running back.
Was almost an offsides there. Looked like two of the linemen on the Knights almost jumped. Snaps off. It's high. And he grabs it. Turnover on downs, I believe. Wait, no, it's fourth down.
Loss of about 5-6 yards by the Rebels.
Fourth and 16.
This is a tough situation to be in. They're going to have to either pass or make a very good run to get that first down.
They're punting. Oh, it looks like Knights didn't know that they were punting, and it's picked up on the 20-yard line.
Jackson Jones with the catch right there from the Rebels.
Looks like Knights will be on offense on the 22-yard line.
Off goes the Farmington Knights offense. Let's see how Tatum Tinsley likes to call his offense.
The snap is out. He pitches it to Gabe Giuliani, and he's taken down right where they've been.
Brought down by Sam Calloway and multiple other defenders from the Rebels.
Yeah, it looked like quite a dog pile there, and Knights are back in their huddle. They look like they're doing a great job. The Rebels, they look pretty packed out there. They seem like they have a lot of great players out there, too.
Whatever the Knights seem to throw at the Rebels seem to be ready for it, able to read, find out where the ball is immediately.
The snap is off, and it's given to Case McLean, number 26 on the Farmington Knights, and he's taken down by
That is Eli Rasnick.
Number two.
That was a very good run for Casey McLean with a carry of about 4 to 5 yards. Very good run, just what the offensive need.
Tatum Tinsley's doing a pretty good job already. I believe that he will be in all game tonight because
Brett Dry is injured.
Snaps off, and it's pitched over to Casey McLean.
Multiple people there on the tackle. Couldn't really tell on that one.
Every time the Knights seem to pitch the ball off to their running backs or fullbacks, their defense seems to read it immediately and get there right to the ball.
Gonna make a short run here. Maybe a little pass. Get the first down.
Let's see that offense be the playmakers.
Fourth down and 1 yard to go. Oh, there's a jump. Offsides. Can't really tell who it's against yet because there was linemen who jumped offsides and, oh, Casey McLean jumped offsides too. They'll be taken 5 yards back and they're currently on the 26-yard line. They are 4th and 6 right now.
The Farmington Knights punt team seems to be running out there. About to go kick that ball as far as possible.
End zone punting off for the Knights. Snapped, and it's off. That was about, I'd say, 40-50-yard kick, and it is out of bounds.
Very good kick by Ian Zoner. He's been taking a lot of good stuff this season. He's been going very good. He's starting corner. He's starting kicker. He is doing very, very well this season.
Looks like the Rebels will be back on offense now, and they are on the 37-yard line. 1st and 10. Quarterback for the Rebels is number 5, Casey Murphy. I believe he just came back from a knee injury. It looks like he's wearing a brace tonight. And it's handed off to number 1, Karen Harlow. Sorry.
Tackled by Gabe Giuliani.
Cannon Harlow, sorry. There's a motion. It's handed off back to number 1, Cannon Harlow. And he's down the field. Spin move. And he's taken down. That'll be a first down for the Central Rebels.
Brought down by Casey McLean.
That will be a good run for the defense, or offense. Good takedown by Casey McLean. Let's see how good the offense can put up with that.
The snap is up. It's a pass. And it's thrown to number 3. And that looks like it's a flag.
Pass interference on, looks, Ian Zoner.
Ian Zoner with a push-off. Number 3 pushing him out of bounds. You're good, Ian Zoner.
I believe that'll be 10 yards.
That'll be
1st and 10 on the 30-yard line.
First down for the Rebels.
Job on the carry. He takes it outside.
Looks like he was tackled by Gabe Giuliani.
Oh. They are 2nd and 9 right now on the 29-yard line.
Seems like our Farmington Knights seem to have quite the cheers for them.
Oh, and that is a touchdown for Central Rebels. Looked like the QB tossed it off for Joe Bryant, and he threw it in for a touchdown. Kicking the field goal for Central Rebels is number 30, Nick Fowler. And it is good. Looks like the Central Rebels will be now kicking off to the Knights, and kicking will be Nick Fowler again.
Let's see if our kick return can return that ball for a pretty big gain of yards.
Okay, we're at break, guys. Okay, give me 5 seconds over the walkie and I'll make sure we're cued when we come back on. We're back. Let's go.
Receiving for the Knights looks like Josh McCarthy and Case McLean. Josh is down the field. He breaks every tackle.
He's going. I think that'll be a touchdown for the Knights.
On a kickoff return.
Freshman Joshua McCarthy. He's a freshman, number 40, just scored a kick return touchdown. Oh my goodness.
Looks like it was from the 15-yard line.
That kid is a freshman. Can you believe it?
Joshua McCarthy's varsity teammates seem to be pretty stoked for that freshman. Let's go, Josh McCarthy. Good stuff.
You can see Anderson Tischer over there freaking out.
Let's not forget, by the way, Joshua McCarthy is a freshman starting on varsity.
Number. Yep. Kicking the field goal for the Farmington Knights is number 12, Ian Zoner again. And it's good.
Ian Zoner's been very proficient this season. He's a very, very good kicker. He's pretty athletic.
Going to break, 7-7, tied game. We will be back after this on BKTV. Coming back from break, welcome back. It is 7-7, first quarter still.
Looks like kicking off for the Knights will be number 12, Ian Zoner, and receiving for the Central Rebels is number 11, Joe Bryant, and number 3, Braden Berry. Zoner's running up to kick, and it's off. Looks like it was a pop, and it's received by, I can't see his number.
looks like he was tackled by multiple people.
Number 7, Caden Casey with the return.
Quite the dog pile with Farmington Knights.
Casey McLean with the tackle, though.
Looks like the Central Rebels are back on offense now. Looks like Farmington Knights are still doing the three safeties and three linemen and three linebackers. This looks like a new formation for the Knights. And the handoff is to number 11, Joe Bryant, and he is taken down by
Caleb Leisk.
Caleb Leisk.
That'll be a first down for the Rebels. Rebels are off on offense. Let's see how they do.
Snap is off, and it's a pass. Looks like it goes to number 31. And he's taken down on the 40.
He's taken,
forced out of bounds.
Taken down by Casey McLean. Pushed out of bounds. Tackled. Right in the...
The Central Rebels seem to be pushing our defense back and back each play, getting that first down.
Looks like they're about to start again. The snap is off. It looks like another pass play. And it's thrown to 11, Joe Bryant. And he breaks three tackles, runs down the middle, taken down by
Gabe Giuliani.
That was a great tackle there by Gabe Giuliani. It looked like he wrapped up and forced him down to the ground.
First down again for the Rebels. Come on, defense.
And they snap the ball. It's another pass, and it is straight to number 7.
Number 7, Caden Casey with the touchdown.
Looks like their one-point attempt is going to be kicked by number 30 again, which is Nick Fowler.
Let's see if our defense can stop that kick.
The ball is snapped, and it's good.
Going to break. Score will be 7-14. Rebels with the lead. We'll be back after this on BKTV.
Most money covers the car the most wins. So get out your wallets and give some money.
Says who?
You're supposed to be like...
Coming back from break, welcome back. 7-14, Knights are losing, 14 by Rebels. First quarter still.
Number 3 kicking off for the Central Rebels is Braden Berry. It's off. Received by Josh McCarthy, number 40. He takes it to the right side, he goes down the field, and he is taken down on the 44-yard line.
He's taken down by number 3, Braden Berry.
Good run by Joshua McCarthy. Good gain of yards.
And it looks like the Knights are back on offense.
See if our offense can make a big play here. Tatum Tinsley calling on their offense, leading that ball.
Tatum Tinsley is playing quite the sport this year.
Oh, yeah.
Sophomore starting at QB. He's doing a great job. The snap is off. taken. And he is taken down with a first down.
I believe he's taken down by number 11, Joe Bryant.
That'll be a first down for the Knights. Tatum Tinsley calling his offense.
Sorry, we were testing to make sure the scaffolding was out of the shot if he panned all the way to the end zone.
They're all lining up. They got quite the time.
Now he's back on the players and back in commission and should not have any more issues with the scaffolding.
And the snap is off, and it's handed off to number 26, Case McClain.
Brought down by number 58, Sam Callaway.
Good tackle by our defense.
I think he meant Central Rebels defense.
You're
Knights
right,
on
Jesper.
Offense.
Looks like the Knights are back out of their huddle. They're all lined up.
We got Jack Embry and Sam Woodson lining up for our two wide receivers.
And it's a pass.
It's a pass
to
oh,
Jack Embry.
To
and
Jack
it is
Embry.
Incomplete.
Pass to number four. Jack Embry is incomplete.
Tatum Tinsley calling his offensive huddle.
Takes the ball. He hands it off to Gabe Giuliani, and Gabe breaks a few tackles and is forced out of bounds.
He was pushed out of bounds by Central Rebels defense. 49, Jackson Jones.
Quite a good run for our Farmington Knights offense by Gabe Giuliani.
He has had quite the senior year.
Yes, he has, Judge.
I think Gabe Giuliani is a great sport. I love that guy. I talk to him a whole lot. He's pretty amazing at football.
Yes, he is.
Knights are back out on the field again. Snap is off. And it looks like it's taken by Tatum Tinsley, and he's taken down.
Taken down by number 49. That would be Jackson Jones.
That'll be a first down for our Farmington Knights.
Knights are back in the huddle. Looks like Tatum is pushing himself. He's doing a whole lot to get those first downs.
Got that right. Being a sophomore starting on varsity, quarterback, it's a lot to handle.
Yeah.
A lot to take in. See how he calls his offense.
They're all lined up. It's taken, and it's pitched by Tatum to Gabe Giuliani.
Brought down by number 3, Braden Berry, and number 7, Caden Casey.
They're back in the huddle, and looks like they're going to take their time.
That'll be a short game of yards for the Farmington Knights.
Lined up. Snap is off, and it's handed off to Casey McClain. He takes it down the middle.
Brought down by number 73, Silas Richardson.
That'd be a good gain of yards for the Knights.
The Knights are third down and 3.
Tatum Tinsley calling his offense.
Looks like we have Jack Embry starting on the left side wide receiver tonight.
Sammy Woodson on the right side.
The snap is off. Tatum breaks a tackle.
He's brought down by multiple people. Appears to be number 70, Nathan Weinhold.
That'll be a dog pile for the Rebels.
That is a timeout. Oh, into the corner.
Going to break. We'll be back after this on BKTV. Coming back from the break, welcome back. Our score is 7-14 with the Rebels with the lead.
It is second quarter and it looks like the Knights will be on the, I want to say, 27-yard line. The snap is off. Handoff is taken by Gabe Giuliani.
He got hit by Braden Berry, forcing him to get down.
That'll be a first down for the Knights. We'd like to thank our sponsors of the night, Coldwell Banker Reality in Farmington and Auto Plaza. Thank you.
Looks like they're back on the line, and there's a motion, and Tatum takes it. He takes it down the middle.
Brought down by multiple defenders.
That'll be a good gain of yards for the Knights.
That was a great read there by the linebackers. The linebackers seemed to find where he was and take him down.
Rebels defense seems to be stopping our offense pretty well.
Jackson Jones seems to be a pretty good, valuable player to the Central Rebels defense.
Got that right, Jasper.
And the snap is off, and it is taken by Case McLean right down the middle.
That is a dog pile from the Central Rebels defense.
Quite the good stop there by the Rebels.
His helmet came off on that one.
And I believe Chase Buchanan going in for him. And then Gabe Giuliani is being taken out, and Josh McCarthy is going in at A. Josh McCarthy has had quite the year this year for his first year in high school, and he's a freshman this year as a starter on varsity. He's second string on offense and first string on defense.
Let's see how Joshua McCarthy can function. Second string, varsity, offense. That'd be a timeout by the Knights. Let's give a thank you to our cheerleaders and band members tonight for out here in the cold, a little bit chilly out tonight, performing for our night's section. BEM members played very well on the national anthem. Knights back out on offense.
Looks like Gabe is back out there.
Case McClain seems to be back out there too.
Oh yeah, I didn't see that. Oh, he's taken back out. Yep, looks like Kaysen's being taken out and Chase Buchanan's going out there.
See how Tatum Tinsley operates his offense.
The snap is up and it's taken by Chase and he is taken down.
That is Jackson Jones with the tackle. Not really a tackle, just wrapped up.
Case McClain going back out there. Chase Buchanan coming back to the sideline.
Looked like he was just forced back a bit.
That'll be fourth and third. See how Tatum Tinsley calls his offense. That's what he said.
They are fourth and one right now. The handoff is taken by, I believe, Chase again. Wait, no, is that Kaysen? And that is a huge dog pile there.
My goodness, that might be a flag. It's number two.
Kaysen McClain.
Number two, the tackle, Eli Raznick.
That'll be a turnover on downs. Rebels with the ball.
Looks like the handoff is taken by number 11, Joe Bryan.
Stop by number two, Gabe Giuliani.
That'll be a good run for the Rebels with a first down.
Looked like Joe made his way around all of them. He got through that line and found a great gap. The snap is off and handed off to number 11, Joe Bryant, and he's running down the field.
Josh McCarthy with the tackle. Pretty good tackle there.
Yep, Josh McCarthy here. He's seeming to have a great game tonight.
Multiple tackles, a kick return touchdown. Not a lot of people get to see that.
Especially a freshman.
Yeah.
See how we run our defense here.
The snap is off, and it looks like a pass. And it is thrown to number one.
Number one, Kenan Harlow with the catch.
Doesn't look like the Knights offense is very happy about that. Looks like a push off by the wide receiver by the Rebels.
Knights defense. The sideline didn't seem so entertained with that because it looked like they believe it could have been a push-off or a pass interference there.
There was a little bit of contact on that pass. He pushed him just a tad, but it's up to the officials to decide.
They are first down and on the 10. Looks like it's taken by Joe Bryant, and he is in. That was a great run by Job there. Kicking the field goal for the Central Rebels is number 30, Nick Fowler.
He seems to be having a pretty good game tonight with his kicking.
The snap is off. He kicks, and it's no good.
Deflected by the Knights defense.
We'll be going to break. 7-20. Rebels up. We'll be back after this on BKTV. Rebels up. It is second quarter. Rebels kicking off.
Kicking off for the Rebels is number 3, Braden Berry. Receiving for the Knights is number 26, Case McLean, and number 40, Josh McCarthy. The kick is off. It looks like an onside received by Chase Watson, number 38 on the Knights.
Not to be out on offense, let's see how Tatum Tinsley can control his offense.
Looks like Knights are back out on offense on the 50-yard line.
Tim Tinsley is having a pretty good game tonight.
Snap is off, and it looks like it's handed off to the fullback, Kaysen McLean.
Brought down by multiple people. Hard to tell there.
See how the Rebels function their defense tonight against our offense.
Looks like Tatum is doing a great job controlling his offense tonight. Looks like it's a timeout.
Coming back from break. Welcome back.
You guys kind of notice that Farmington, when they're on offense, they're really trying to milk the play clock. They're trying to keep time of possession as much on their side as possible. Central on the other side of things, trying to go for that quick strike offense. We'll see what happens now as the Knights go back to work offensively down 20-7.
They are 2-8 here. Second down with 8 yards to go. The handoff is taken by Gabe Giuliani, and it looks like he breaks a few tackles.
Brought down by number 49, Jackson Jones.
Gabe Giuliani with a great run for the Knights. Just could not take him down.
He took it to the outside and made a play.
Just what our Knights offense needed.
They're lining back up. The snap is off. Looks like Tatum pitches it to number 26, Case McLean, and he is forced out of bounds.
forced out of bounds by number 49, Jackson Jones.
That'll be a first down for the Knights.
We have a great starting lineup for the Farmington Knights on the skilled side of positions. We have number 2, Gabe Giuliani at A. Number 10, Tatum Tinsley at QB. Number 21, Sammy. Sam Woodson at wide receiver, number 21. And then we have number 4, Jack Embry on the left side receiver. Number 27, Connor Rice at H. And number 26, Kaysen McLean at F.
Brought down by number 49, Jackson Jones. There's a flag on the play.
Ian Zoner going in for Jack Embry. Ian Zoner's first time on offense this whole game. Flag against the Rebels.
Ian is put out on left side wide receiver for the Knights.
See how Ian can make a play.
The Knights are all lined up. Tatum Tinsley on the carry.
Brought down by number 49, Jackson Jones.
Defense read that play very, very well.
That was a great run there from Tatum. He gained, I'd say, about 4 or 5 yards from that play and got his offense up there. The O-line is all lined up and ready to go.
See how Tatum controls his offense.
The snap is off and handed off to number 26, Kaysen McLean, and he is taken down.
Looks like he's hit by number 1, Cannon Harlow, brought him down.
Five minutes left on the second quarter.
Let's give a good thanks to our sponsors, Sugar Fire Barbecue in Farmington, Missouri, and Subway in Farmington. Thank you, sponsors.
The Knights are lining back up. They are 3rd down and 5 right now. Tatum takes it away. He cuts through the middle.
Brought down by number 49, Jackson Jones.
There's a flag on the play.
That'll be a flag on our offense.
Holding against the Knights. They are now 3rd and 12 yards to go.
See if Tatum Tinsley here can make a play.
Knights are coming back out of their huddle, all lining up together. There's a motion, and it's a pass. Looks like Tatum's going to throw it. It's an interception by number 1, Cannon Harlow. Looks like Farmington Knights defense is going to come out now. Now the Central Rebels are going to go on offense again. Central Rebels all right, lined up on the line now. Looks like it's a pass, and it's taken by number one, Kenan Harlow. He takes it to the outside. He's pushing it downfield. Steps out of bounds.
Big play by the offense. Big gain of yards.
He almost took it to the house there. But it looks like he stepped out of bounds right on the 35-yard line. Central Rebel is all lined up and ready to go now. Snap is off and handed off to Joe Bryant, number 11 on the Central Rebels. He takes it down the middle, and it looks like he's gone, and he takes it to the end zone.
Farmington Knights defense just couldn't get him. Quick feet.
I've heard Joe Bryant has had a great past 2 years in the Central Rebels football.
I've heard Joe Burr has had quite the season, actually. He's done very, very, very well.
As well, he has multiple D1 offers in both sports, football and basketball. I heard he has around maybe 30 D1 offers from all sports, maybe even more.
They're going for the 2-point, and it is screen pass.
And it'll be good.
And it is good.
By number one, Kenan Harlow.
Going to break, 28-7, Rebels with the carry. We'll be back after this on BKTV. Coming back from break, welcome back. 28-7, Rebels up. The quarter will be second quarter, 3 minutes left.
Looks like kicking off for the Central Rebels is number 10, Devin Graff.
See how the Rebels kick.
Looks like receiving for the Knights is number 26, Kaysen McLean, and number 40 is Josh McCarthy. It's received by Kaysen on the pop right, and he's just laid down. Looks like the Knights will be back on offense now, and Central Rebels back on defense. Looks like Tatum Tinsley is still doing a good job at quarterback right now. The snap is up, and it's taken by Tatum. And it is a big dog pile.
It's a dog pile by the Central Rebels defense. I think that's mainly number two, Eli Rasnick, for the tackle.
Looks like they are second down and 9 yards to go for a first down here. The Rebels seem to be having a great game here tonight. The carry taken by Connor Rice, number 27.
Pushed out of bounds by Number four, Karis Foster, Social Rebels.
That'll be a big play for the Knights offense.
Looks like they are third down and 4 yards to go for the first down.
Let's see how Tatum Tinsley does.
What was a dog pile. Brought down by number 49 though. Jackson Jones potential.
And the carry by Casey McLean.
Down by Central Rebels D-line mainly. Dog pile there. Multiple dog piles this game.
That Rebel defensive line's been really, really good all night for Central. They've done a nice job stifling Farmington's offense. They've had a couple drives where they've been able to get it into Central territory, take it deep, but everything is stalled out ultimately, and the only touchdown tonight for the Knights coming off a special teams return for a touchdown by the freshman Josh McCarthy. Yeah, here we go. Rebels taking hardly any time to get up and down the field.
Snap is off. It's a screen pass to number three right there.
Tackled by Connor Rice.
Sorry. Number 31, Barry Hanson.
A well-designed play that time. Hinson just runs a curl to the far side sideline. The receiver out there on the far side was able to run down the field, open things up for him. Nice play call, nice game for the Rebels.
Snap is off, and it looks like it is a pass, and it is caught by number one, Shannon Harlow, in the end zone. Touchdown for the Central Rebels.
Wow, just a great pattern to the corner of the end zone there for Harlow, and he's able to make the catch and score again. A great pass as well, and Central has really figured some things out offensively now, and they're going to go back to trying to attempt an extra point here as they lead in this ball game now 34-7.
30, kick and field goal, Nick Fowler for the Central Rebels. He kicks it, and it is good.
So Central leads Farmington 35-7. We're back after this on BK TV.
Central Rebels Group is a proud sponsor of the Farmington Knights and wishes each athlete the best of luck this season. Pettis Auto Group is proud to serve our friends in the Parkland area and has built quite a reputation as the leading automotive expert in Eastern Missouri. Whether you're in the market for a new or used Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram, we have you covered. Thank you to our many loyal customers who trust the Pettis Auto Group for their car buying needs. Let's go now.
Jimmy Johnson,
runner online. Kicking off for the Rebels, number 10, Devin Graff. Back to receive for the Knights, number 40, Josh McCarthy.
The score is 35 with the Rebels in the lead and 7 for the Knights. Kicking off for the Central Rebels now.
Number 10, Tatum Tinsley with the keeper. Stop by number 58, Sam Callaway. Complete to number 21, Sam Woodson. Brought down by number 3, Braden Berry. Number 7, Caden Casey. That'll be a Farming Tonight. First down. Pass intended for number 2, Gabe Giuliani, is incomplete. Intended for number 2, Gabe Giuliani is incomplete.
That'll be it.
The offense is working on trying to move that ball, trying to get a touchdown so we can have a comeback.
Central Rebels seem to be stopping us very well.
Case McClain, he takes it down the middle and he's running downfield. And
he is brought down by number 11, Joe Bryant.
That'll be for me tonight. First down.
Snap is off and it is pitched over to Gabe Giuliani.
Brought down by number 2, Eli Rasnick.
Brought down by number 2, Eli Rasnick. And timeout, Farmington.
That will be a timeout for Farmington tonight, too.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ryan Blankenship, insurance brokerage, is the clear choice when it comes to auto, home, and business coverages. Over 15 years, they've built a strong game plan to get their customers the best value for their insurance. With a team of over 50 insurance carriers, they're the favorite against competitors. Good coverage and saving money is a win-win situation. Find them online at rbibrokerage.com. Ryan Blankenship Insurance Brokerage is the proud supporter of Farmington Athletics and is the teammate that you need for insurance coverage.
See if the Farmington Knights offense can make a big play here.
Good.
Snap is off. It looks like a pass. Taking his time. He takes the run. And he is not in.
Number 10, Tatum Tinsley with the keeper.
Brought down by number 70.
Brought down number 11, Joe Bryant.
Excuse me, number 11, Joe Bryant.
Let's see Tatum Tinsley make a play here.
Connor Rice, number 27, lined up next to number 10, Tatum Tinsley. Oh.
Timeout Farmington.
Timeout Farmington.
Ladies and gentlemen, before life hits you like that blitzing linebacker, make sure you have the proper protection in place for you and your family.
We'd like to thank our sponsors, the Ryan Blankenship Insurance Agency and Domino's in Farmington, Missouri.
With hundreds of unique items arriving every week, Hood's Discount Home Centers offer something for everyone. From contractor grade to total custom, Hood's can provide you with affordable, quality products. Come by today and see why it's all Hood at Hood's Discount Home Center.
Knights and Rebels coming back out into the field now. Snap is off and is thrown to number 21, Sam Woodson. Intercepted.
Pass intercepted by number one, Cannon Harlow.
Number one, Cannon Harlow.
That'll be a turnover on downs.
Get ready for the marching band performance. This is one of the coolest parts of this.
Excuse him, that was an interception in the end zone, not a turnover on downs.
They will now be on the 20-yard line for the first down and 10 yards to go for the defense.
No, I like where you're at. It's actually a few minutes.
Let's see the Knights defense stop the Rebels.
Looks like it's a pass. It is received by number one and lateraled over to number 11, Joe Bryant, and he takes it down the field.
Tackled by number 40, Josh McCarthy.
That was a great run by Joe Bryant there. That was a great pass by number 5, Cason Murphy.
That was a big play by the Central Rebels.
That was a smart play, too.
That'll be halftime.
This is not something you see often. Very good lateral.
There they are, ladies and gentlemen, the 2023-2024 Nightline. Ladies and gentlemen, while the band is setting up, I will announce that there has been a winner in the lottery ticket filled Yeti cooler, and the winner is Tanner Morgan. Gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, we proudly present the 2023 Black Knight Marching Band. Tonight, the band will be presenting their show titled Andale. Drum majors Kenzie Drennan, Eli Sullivan, and Michael Williams, is your band ready? Marching band, you may take the field.
Thank you.
Right there!
Thank you.
home in the 2023 Black Knight Marching Band. Black Knight Marching Band staff members include Ashley Chilton, Taylor Moulton, Michelle Strobel, Joe Strobel, Mary Porter, and Elliot Nays. Student leadership team members include Elena Pulliam, Elizabeth Yeager, Chuck Warren, Cale Dixon, Eli Halleck, Levi Cowley, Zach Gallagher, Corbin Halfley, Sienna Cloudis, Grayson Pratt, Emma Jones, Kenzie Drennan, Eli Sullivan, and Michael Williams. Gentlemen, Big Tom Technologies has been serving businesses, government, and education markets throughout Southeast Missouri since 1998. We believe that it is our best interest or best business to know how technology can work for your business. We will provide the right products, friendly service, and professional experience for your solution. We have technicians on staff with more than 109 years of combined experience. Get connected today with one of our specialized associates to see how we can bring you results. Safe and secure instant issue debit cards for all our customers. 32,000 free ATMs nationwide and secure internet banking from anywhere. Our residential real estate loan decisions are made locally and our loans are serviced locally. We are a mutual. As a customer, you are an owner. Construction has been building beautiful, durable, cost-effective buildings and spaces for the Farmington area for over 90 years. Our talented, dedicated staff builds trust and lasting relationships to make every Brock Miller experience a good one. Brock Miller Construction's commitment to client service has kept us on the cutting edge of construction business for over 90 years. First State Community Bank is here to help you meet your financial goals. Our mobile banking app offers a convenient way to check account balances, make deposits, transfers, and pay bills. First State Community Bank, serving Farmington since 1954. Success starts here. Ladies and gentlemen, you deserve extraordinary care close to home. From primary care to advanced specialties right here in Farmington, with access to all that BJC Healthcare has to offer. Parkland Health Center and BJC Healthcare are here to provide the care you need. Care that is comprehensive, coordinated, and completely about you. Learn more at parklandhealthcenter.org. Farmington R7 School District would like to thank the following local businesses for partnering with us on our new turf and video boards project: Mobile Banker Holsey Real Estate, Midwest Health Network, Parkland Health Center, Brock Miller Construction, Kid Account School Dismissal System by Midtown Technologies, First State Community Bank, Hood's Discount Home Center, Chris Morrison State Farm Insurance, Ozark Federal Savings and Loan, Cozine's Chapel, Crystal Heating and Cooling, First State Financial Management and Insurance Agency, Gifford Lumber Company, Insight Partners Steak and Shake, CC's and Qdoba, Tobias Heating and Cooling, Pasta House, Pettis Automotive, and Chaz Follis. Midwest Orthopedics Pain and Spine Care. Orthopedic Care, Dr. Scott Van Ness, Thomas Burke Bigler, and Jesse Beard with Nurse Practitioner Tanya Kennedy. Foot and Ankle Surgery and Podiatry Care, Dr. Brian Martin. Family Practice Doctor, Dr. James Moore with Nurse Practitioner Rebecca Buchanan. Chiropractic and Pain Management Services Doctor, Stephen Orr, Mark Medley, Michael Fan, Tom Zhu with Nurse Practitioner Lacey Sullivan, and Physical Therapist.
Score is still 35 for Park Hills and 7 for Farmington.
Just a few seconds here until both teams go out on the field and the kickoff begins.
Whether you are on the market for a new or used Ford, Ram, we have you covered. Thank you to our many loyal customers who trust the Pettis Auto Group for their car buying needs. Let's go back.
Now, during the first half, there was a whole lot of action. There was back and forth on the first and second and third and fourth down.
Kicking off for the Rebels, number 10, Devin Graff. And it's off. Deep kick to Corbin Phillips, number 42. Tackled at the 44-yard mark.
And that was a great run by Corbin. He made his teammates. Like his offensive teammates down to
34 yard line. Number 31, Barrett Pinson with that tackle.
Kevin Tinsley calling the huddle. Kevin Tinsley with the handoff to
Number two, Gabe Giuliani.
Brought down by number 70, it appears, Nathan Weinhold.
Number 70, Nathan Weinhold.
That was a great run there from Gabe Giuliani there. He actually has had quite the year this year. He does a whole lot of running and a whole lot of catching. And he has done quite a lot for the teams.
Kevin Tinsley with the break on the huddle.
Tatum with the give to Gabe Giuliani. Tackle for a loss of 1 yard.
Brought down by number two, Eli Raznick.
Eli Raznick, number 58, Sam Callaway.
Yeah, that was a great tackle though. Eli seemed like quite the athlete for the Sunday.
Tatum Tinsley figuring out what the play call is. Break with the huddle, everybody getting in their positions. And snapped. Tatum Tinsley draws back to pass. He's running back, scrambles. Juking out the defenders left and right.
That was a great scramble there from Tatum to get away from those defenders there. He juked one. I think he broke a few tackles, maybe. But he kept his team where they needed to be. But right now, the Knights will be punting.
Fourth down. Ian Zoner with the punt. Receiving for the Rebels. Number 11, Jay Boat.
Joe Bryan with the ball.
He's running up the field.
He's
brought down by number 23, Case.
That was a great run there from Joe. He actually broke plenty of tackles there. This looked like they
Snap is given to Joe Bryant. He's going. Flag thrown on the play.
Brought down by number 26, Casey McClain.
Keeper. Stopped by number 26, Casey McClain. There's a flag on the field.
Flag on the Rebels.
Official call on the field, holding against the Rebels.
Flag on the field, called by an official, holding, 5 yard penalty.
Is my mic working?
Number 5 with the give. Give to number 42.
Brought down by number 22. From the Farm tonight.
Thank you.
Snap is drawn back by number 5. Ball thrown to Joe Bryant. Tackle by...
It's brought down by number 26, Casey McClain.
That was a great tackle there by Casey McClain. He made a great read there and made his way to the runner, Joe Bryan, and found his way to tackle him.
Flag on the field. Against the Rebels, 5 yard penalty. Holding. See the Rebels make a play.
Yeah, Rebels are currently second, and I want to say about 21 yards away from a first down.
Number 5 with the drawback. Pass complete to number 11, Joe Bryant.
Brought down by number 40, Joshua McCarthy.
With a gain of about 3.
Number 22, Chase Buchanan, being taken out for Caleb Leask to come in.
Number 5 with the snap. Draws it back. Scrambling. He's got a hole. He's going, and he runs out of bounds.
That was a great run there from number 5, Cason Murphy. He made his way to get back up 10 from the first down, and I think they're going to go for it.
That'll be fourth down.
Fourth and 10, and they are
punting the ball.
Received by Caleb Leask. Oh, sorry.
He's brought down by number 55, Logan Murray.
That'd be a turnover.
Looks like Knights are back on offense here now. And they seem like they are on the 43-yard line.
Cam Tinsley with the snap. Giving it to Casey McClain.
Brought down by number 49 and tripped over a few people. Brought down by number 49, Jackson Jones.
For a gain of about 3 yards.
Yeah, that was a great tackle there by Jackson Jones. He has had quite the game tonight, and he seems like quite the athlete as a linebacker.
Cam Tinsley with the snap. He'll keep it. And he's pushed back.
That's a dog pile there. Put down by number 49, Jackson Jones, and number 2, Eli Resnick.
Farmington Knights are lined back up on the ball here now.
Third down. Tatum Tinsley with the ball. Draws it back.
Interception!
By number 49.
Brought down by number 2, Gabe Giuliani. The pass was intended to Gabe. It was intercepted. Brought down by number 21, Sam Wilson.
Knights are back on defense now while the Central Rebels go back on offense here.
Big play by the Rebels. Quarterback keeps it. Oh wait, that's Joe Bryant.
Tripped up. Brought down by number 2, Gabe Giuliani.
Seems like Job has had quite the game tonight as well. Seems like Job has actually had a great year this year. I have heard a whole lot of Job, and everything I've heard from him has been good. Seems like he's quite the athlete in football and basketball.
Number 5, brought down immediately.
It's brought down by number 40, Joshua McCarthy. Watch the player there.
Joe Bryant with the carry.
It is 3rd and 2 now, as the Central Rebels are going to try and push this up to get this first down.
Number 5 with the give to Joe Bryant. He's going, and he steps out of bounds.
That is a first down, Central Rebels.
Number 5 with the snap. Throws it to number 1. Pass is complete. He's staying up. That'll be a first down for the Rebels.
Looks like he was forced a bit out of bounds there. He almost made the play, but looked like he just got that foot out. That happened earlier to him, too. He was almost into the end zone, and then he got taken down. Or no, he didn't get taken down. He stepped out. Just by a hair.
Number 5 with the snap. Given to number...
Brought down by number 56, Luke Berkman.
Handoff to Barrett Henson, number 31 for the Central Rebels. He took it to the outside and he got taken down. It is 2nd down and I believe 6 yards to go for the next first down here.
Number 5 with the snap, draws it back. Ball thrown to number 3, and it is incomplete. Five with the snap, draws it back. Pass to Joe Bryant. Take it.
Take
back.
It down by number 2, Gabe Giuliani.
For the loss of yards.
It'll be 4th down and I believe 3 yards to go for the next first down for the Central Rebels here, and they are doing a great job this game. Currently winning 35-7. And with 3:45 left in the 3rd quarter. They had a great first half of this game, and I don't know if they've scored yet this half, have they?
No, they have not. Number 5 with the snap gives it to number 1.
Brought down by number 59, Bryce Cathcart. First down for the Rebels.
The number 5 with the snap. Throws it back. Pass to number 7.
And he was forced out of bounds by number 7 on the Knights, Rhett Coughlin.
Number 5 with a snap. Give to number 11, Joe Bryant.
And I believe that is a touchdown for the Central Rebels. Their field goal team is coming back out here to try and score this field goal. Number 30 for the Central Rebels kicking this field goal, Nick Fowler.
Snap is up, and kick, and no good.
Going to break. Score is 41.
Extra point is no good. Ladies and gentlemen, Coldwell Banker, Holsey Real Estate has been a part of the farming community for 59 years, helping you locate that hard-to-find property. Go to our agent's page and email or call one of our experienced agents so they can assist you in your search for your dream home, land, farm, or commercial property.
Coming back from break. Welcome back. The score is currently 41 for the Central Rebels and 7 for the Farmington Knights with 2 minutes and 40 seconds left in the third quarter.
Kick is up by number 10, pop to right field. And the Knights got it. Sat down right on it. Given to Casey McClain.
Casey McClain with the carry.
Brought down by number 70.
Brought down by number 70, Nathan Weinhold.
Kinsley with the snap. Ball given to Gabe Giuliani.
It's a dog pile there.
Fumble on the play, recovered by the Rebels.
Rebels will now be back on offense here, and Knights will be back on defense. Looks like it's going to be first down for the Rebels, and 10 yards to go for the next first. Snap is up, and it is given to Job as he runs down the middle. when he is taken down.
Brought down by number 27, Connor Rice.
Number 11, Job.
That was a great run there from Job. He made it through and got another first down for his teammates there.
First down for the Rebels.
Connor Rice had a great tackle there. That was a great play for Connor Rice, and he's been doing pretty good this game. Oh! Job is on the run. He made it through. He broke a few tackles, and he's taken down.
Taken down by number 7, Rhett Coughlin.
It is 1st and 10 for the Central Rebels currently, and they're going to try to go for the touchdown here soon. It's a pass. He's scrambling. Pass is complete to number 7.
Pass complete to number 7, Caden Casey.
Caden Casey.
First and goal for the Rebels.
It'll be 1st and goal for the Central Rebels. Be a touchdown for the Central Rebels.
Number 3, Braden Berry, in for the touchdown.
Kicking this field goal for the Central Rebels is number 30, once again, Nick Fowler.
Seconds remaining in quarter number 3. So that's going to make the clock go faster in the fourth quarter. So what's going to happen is basically unless a timeout is called or there's an injury, they're not going to stop play, or stop the clock rather, during this fourth quarter because of the score. So again, it's 47-7 with 5 seconds left. We'll go ahead and keep right here as we'll have a break after this kickoff.
Now receiving for the Knights is number 26, Casey McLean, and number 40, Josh McCarthy. Kicking off for the Central Rebels is once again number 10, Devin Graff.
Brought down by number 31, Garrett Henson.
Number 42, Corbin Phillips with the return.
Let's go ahead and take us to break there, Alexander.
At this time, Keeklum would like to give a special shout out to our amazing sponsors. We wanted to give a special thank you to our main sponsors, Amberlin's Boutique, Kiwanis Club of Farmington, Sherry's Quick Trip, Unique Custom Flooring. Luna Realty, Green Acres Residential Facilities, Barhouse Supplies, American Family Insurance, and Subway. Thank you for supporting such a great cause, and thank you to everyone who came out to help support tonight.
Coming back from break, welcome back. Score is 47 Rebels, 7 Knights, and the quarter is fourth quarter with 12 minutes on the clock.
Ball is on the 36-yard line.
Looks like Knights are back on offense again, and the Central Rebels are back on defense.
Brought down by number 33, Alex Eichenmeyer.
Chase Buchanan, number 22 on the carry, though.
Tatum Tinsley calling the play in the huddle, trying to lead his Farmington Knights to at least another touchdown for this quarter. Tatum Tinsley with the snap, given to Parker Brooks, number 14.
Knocked down by number 40, Max Woods.
Looks like there's a flag on the play for delayed hit out of bounds. They pushed him out of bounds, and then someone shoved the entire pile down.
Very fair play there.
Looks like the Knights sideline did not like that at all.
I was going a little wild on that flag.
Crowd did not like that at all. Tatum Tinsley breaks the huddle. Tatum with the snap. Ball given to Parker Brooks. He's going, breaking tackles left and right.
Brought down by number 21, Colin Husley.
That was a great run there by Parker. First couple plays of the game on offense here. He's doing a great job for the Farmington Knights.
Tatum breaks the huddle. Snap is up. Given to Parker Brooks. And he'll be down.
Brought down by multiple people.
That will be a Farmington Knights first down.
Tatum Tinsley with the pitch to Connor Rice. He's going.
That is a touchdown, Farmington Knights. Kicking the field goal for the Farmington Knights here will be number 12, Ian Zoner. He has been kicking for us all game tonight, and he has been doing a great job.
Snap is up. Kick is going, and it's good. That'll be an extra point for the Farmington Knights.
Going to break. Score is 47, Central, 13, Knights. We'll be back after this on BKTV.
Thank you.
coming back from break. Welcome back. Score is 47 Central Rebels and 14 the Farmington Knights. Kicking off for the Farmington Knights is number 12 Ian Zoner, and receiving for the Central Rebels is number 21 Colin Hulsey, and I can't really see his number. I believe
kick is up and it's going.
Number 30, Nick Fowler.
Brought down by number 38, Chase Watson from tonight.
Farmington Knights will be back on defense here now, and the Central Rebels are back on offense.
Ball snapped to number 5. Ball is given to
brought down by multiple people. Number 42, Corbin Phillips with the tackle.
Number 30,
on the carry.
Nick Fowler. Looks like the Central Rebels are lining back up. With number 11, Joe Bryant, back at QB.
Looked down by number 26, Casey McClain. He's a very good linebacker, Casey McClain. Very athletic, very quick. He's got some strength on him, too. Very good linebacker for the Farmington Knights this year. He's a junior. He's their starting running back. Also starts on both sides of the ball. He's a very good, valuable football player.
Good run for the Central Rebels.
Right down by number 40, Josh McCarthy. Someone's injured in this play.
There's an injury out on the field. Trainer sprinting out on the field.
40, Josh McCarthy and 27, Connor Rice.
Looks like a Farmington Knight player down on the field.
Coming back from break,
Welcome back. Score is currently 47 for the Central Rebels and 14 for the Farmington Knights. Central Rebels on offense.
Number 5 with the give.
Number 47 with the carry.
Brought down by number 59. Pass Bryce Cathcart.
There's another freshman out on the field, Coy Fripp. Transferred from Watertown, Tennessee last year. Pass is gone.
Incomplete.
Pass is in for number 30, Nick Fowler is incomplete.
Ian Zoner coming off the field. Chase Watson out of the field on left corner. Brought down by number 14, Parker Brooks.
The Central Rebels lining back up on the ball. They are 4th and 7 right now. Low snap.
Snap is low.
Oh,
punch
it was a punt. And it looks like it's going to go out of bounds. Right on the 26-yard line. Farmington Black Knights are going to be back on offense now. Hudson Buchanan coming in for Sam Woodson at wide receiver now.
Personal foul against the Knights.
We would like to thank some of our sponsors here tonight. Jimmy Johns in Farmington, Missouri. Shelter Insurance Agent Brian Larimore. And Sugar Fire Barbecue in Farmington, Missouri.
Rebels will have the ball. Knights on defense. Five of the snap. Ball given.
Put down by multiple people.
Ball given to number 47.
with the carry. Draw down by number 59, Bryce Cathcart.
They are second and 6 yards to go for a first down.
We have another freshman out on the field, Anderson Tissue. One of our favorite linemen here at Farmington Knights.
Timeout, Farmington.
Timeout, Farmington Knights. Going to break. Coming back from break, welcome back. The score is currently 47 Central Rebels and 14 Farmington Knights. And it is the fourth quarter with 5 minutes left.
Ball is given to number 17.
Brought down by number 74, Anderson Tischer, freshman.
The current freshmen's out there right now are Coy Fripp, number 19, transferred from Watertown, Tennessee last year, and Anderson Tischer, number 74, and Hunter Lynn, number 63. The Central Rebels are back on offense. The snap is good.
And number 47.
Number 47, George Whaley with the carry. Brought down by number 14, Parker Brooks.
Sides by the Central Rebels from number 6.
Flag on the field.
Kyron Goodson. Goodson.
Call on the field, false start against the Rebels.
Rebels back out on the field. Fourth down. Snap is up, given to number 5. Number 5 passes on to 52. Doesn't get very far.
And that will be a turnover on downs. That was a great tackle there.
Brought down by number 62.
Wyatt McDowell.
Knights will be on offense now.
First and 10 on the 44-yard line.
Jackson Tinsley, another freshman out there for the Knights.
At QB.
See what you can do here, getting varsity reps.
Snap is up, given to Hudson Buchanan. Chase Buchanan, I mean. Excuse me.
Brought down by number 12, Jonathan Boyer.
Jackson Tinsley controlling his offense, calling the plays in the huddle right now.
Tatum Tinsley's younger brother. Pretty cool to see brothers out there playing the same position.
Snap is up, given to Chase Buchanan with a gain of about three.
Number 22, Chase Buchanan, looked to carry.
That was a great run there by Chase to gain some yards. They're currently on third down right now as they try and push up to get the first down.
Good little tackle there from number 33, Alex Ackermeyer.
Snap is up to Jackson Tinsley, pitched off to Caleb Leask, number 6. Trying to stay up, break the tackle.
First down, Farmington Knights there.
Good tackle by number 24, Buddy McIntyre.
Farmington Knight, first down.
Two more freshmen come back onto the field with another freshman coming out and Hudson Buchanan coming out. Chase Buchanan.
A.J. Robbins at QB now, number 18, and Coy Fripp going in at A.
Parker Brooks with the carry, brought down by multiple people. Flag on the play, number 33, Alex Ackermeyer. He just hit another player. Ryder Lynn.
Sorry, Coy Fripp at F.
Flag on the Rebels. That'll be a gain of... That'll be a first down for the Knights.
That was a great play there that they had, and... The Farmington Knights seem to be putting out a lot of freshmen and letting them get their playing time of the game.
Snap is up, A.J. Robbins, give to Coy Fripp, and he's gone! Touchdown, Farmington!
Coy Fripp, the freshman, with for the Farmington Knights varsity reps, gets a touchdown. What a player.
Playing a position he doesn't normally play, believe it or not.
Zona with the kick.
The snap is good, and it's up, and it's in. Going to break, the score currently is 47 Central and 21 Farmington. Coming back from break, welcome back. The score is 47 Central and 21 Farmington with 52 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Ian Zoner with the kickoff.
Kicking off for the Knights, number 12, Ian Zoner. Back to receive for the Rebels, number 30, Nick Fowler. And number 21, Alan Holt.
Ian Zoner with the kick. It's up, popped right.
Brought down by number 12, kicker, Ian Zoner.
as the Farmington Knights defense goes out, the Central Rebels offense comes out. There's a flag on the kickoff play, and it seems to be... against the Knights.
Rebels are just kneeling it.
They're gonna milk the timer. And it looks like the Knights have lost.
Rebels are going to just keep milking timer.
Well, that is it, folks.
That's the
final final score is 47 Central Rebels to 21 the Farmington Knights.
Last game of the season for the Farmington Knights varsity team. So
playoffs will be next week.
Good job out there, Farmington.
Thank you for joining us at BKTV. This is Judge Aubuchon.
This is Jasper Lamont.
This is Xander Davis.
And we would like to say thank you and have an amazing rest of your night. Bye.
He has batteries.